September 12, 2014, about 20 people armed with binoculars and telephoto lenses gather on the roof of a parking garage in downtown Birmingham, Alabama. Their attention is focused on a small, by Birmingham standards, nondescript seven-story building that once served as a Masonic lodge hall. Seen from the ground, the building is unremarkable, but on the side is a feature which has created the event that has drawn these people from over 100 miles away. It's the chimney. It runs the full height of the seven-story building and then some. These people are friends and members of the Birmingham Audubon Society.
Yeah, we're having fun now, huh?
And they are observing the increasingly rare sight of thousands of small birds which are swarming above the chimney. These little birds are chimney swifts, and in a few minutes they will begin to enter the chimney where they will roost for the night.
Oh yeah, I can see them birds. They're flying.
The afternoon has been stormy, and low, wet clouds continue to scuttle across the cityscape.
And also precipitation is out.
In the distance, Vulcan stands watch over his city. Around the birders, the largest buildings of the city loom above their heads. The time is now 7:15. It's about 20 minutes since the sunset. The photographers are struggling to keep up with the fading light. For most of the afternoon, the swifts have been circling the chimney. In fact, they spend almost all of their waking lives airborne. Their tiny legs, powerful feet, allow them to cling to the inside walls of chimneys, but don't allow them to perch on wires or branches like most birds. Thus, they fly. They stay aloft all day while pursuing insect meals. Even water is taken on the wing.
I just heard a night call. Oh, now they're really dropping in.
And then suddenly, in response to some ageless signal or tweak of light, they begin descending into the stack. And before it's over, thousands of these birds will have entered the chimney and attached themselves to the wall. It's said that if disturbed while roosting, the tiny bird will beat its wings against its body two or three times to make a thumping sound. If disturbed inside of a chimney, all several thousand of the birds will simultaneously beat and create a sound described as a deep thunderclap. It's a protective device that serves them well.
We could move over.
We got all I can
get. They're just pouring in.
There's one on the outside.
Oh, is there one on the outside of the chicken?
And then as the photographers push their camera sensors to the limit and the darkness falls so dense that no one can even see the birds without powerful binoculars, it ends. And down the street, a sold-out crowd makes its way into the Alabama Theater for a concert and an evening of fun. They have no idea that a free show has just ended.